CatSynth TV.
Hey everybody, CatSynth TV, and we are at the Lost Church in San Francisco for Word Performances.
Anniversary of Word Performances. We're really thrilled, and we have an all-star lineup for you tonight. And we have Poet Laureate Ma Shein Nguyen and Amanda Chaudhary of Pitta of the Mind, award-winning poet William Taylor Jr., flamenco dancer Damian Alvarez, author Jon Sindell, novelist Crystal Reiss, author Rose Heredia, violinist Hannah Glass, wordsmith Todd Siegel, and myself, poet and performer Cybele Zufolo Siegel.
But I was jealous of other women who had good relationships with their mothers. I also felt like she cared more about my brother than me. While he was a decade older, every time I would call, she and Dad would ask, "So how's your brother?" As if I was his keeper. As if I wasn't important. As if he were the center of their universe. As if talking to me wasn't enough. "I don't feel like we're friends, and I just don't trust you," I'd said, or something in that vein. Mom started to cry. "I don't know how to be friends with women because every woman who was my friend your father slept with," she said. Or maybe she didn't cry. She didn't address my issues with her, only her excuse. No recognition of my concerns with our relationship. No resolutions. Just an explanation for her lack of interest in her daughter.
Empire of sound. Stage abandoned, invisible construct. The gold came through spider web. Lake drop. Retina. Language unrecognized. Seabirds are fire flowers. Sun totems. Blue light leaks through flecks of paint. A message or not. Looks like her. Those tarantula-legged eyebrows. Looks away to remember. Walks into carpeted office. Meat-eating flowers, lightning rods.
Emerson says poetry must be its own ends, or it is nothing. And the poets look troubled, wounded from the Twitter wars of 2018, unsure of their brand, wondering if their contents might be deemed problematic. Emerson says the verse must be alive, inseparable from its contents, as the soul inspires and directs the body. The poets wonder if maybe the algorithms are working against them, worrying they've put stock in obsolete platforms, blacklisted the wrong publications, chosen questionable fonts. Emerson says we measure inspiration by the music, as the poets walk without rhythm through tedious neighborhoods, swiping left like phony gods.
Fee, love, milking brand assets, the hedge of allegiance. Truth is up for grabs. Feel the yearn. We're not burned out, but it's a slippery hope. Click here for a gateway pug. It could be the primary button on a pug lover site, the call to action. What about an AA site? Menace to sobriety. A psychotherapy site. Cry me a river. Procrastination help site. Not so gentle reminders. A public speaking site. Too shy to shine.
Evangelist was relentless. Addicted to zing, he despised blandness, insisting that enlightenment depended upon a hot tongue. During meals, he lectured on the importance of conflagration. No reason was given as to why students should subject taste buds and gut to fire. Instead, all were told that an understanding would come in time. When the avatar ladled curried chicken onto a pile of rice, Jane began to feel ill. When he stabbed a piece of pork loin, prodding it into the center position on his plate like a pregnant woman on a doctor's table, she nearly doubled over. Taking a bite, he nodded and looked around the table. The others hadn't yet filled their plates, and the seats were empty. Soon one, then another, settled down with food, Jane swooning, but building a hill of rice she didn't intend to eat. She laid.
And while I freely confess to experiencing a titillating tingle when Tom squeezed me tight, in consequence of which I would contemplate the pleasure to be afforded by physical congress with Tom's soft, warm, ample leg, the reduction in natural urges that I noticed some years ago upon release from my boyhood imprisonment by the human monster known as the vet ensured that I might rest peacefully in Tom's warm embrace without overheating, if you catch my drift. Free of the distracting influence of carnal lust, I would partake of the more refined pleasure of sniffing the aforementioned t-shirt of Tom, which at times such as these would not have been washed for at least 2 weeks, just as Tom's body would not have been washed, giving the garment and the body alike the delightful fragrance of stinking cheese. In remembering Tom, I must also commend his inquisitive mind. Who's a good dog? He would often inquire. When I would respond with the dignified silence that such an inane query deserves, he would repeat with greater intensity, who's a good dog then? Failing to perceive that my dignity forbade a response, he would proffer the abusive, absurd interrogative yet again, for which reason I identified persistence as another of Tom's chief attributes. To persistence, I would add helpfulness. For Tom would invariably conclude these exhausting interviews with the grand exclamation, you are. You're a good dog.
Cryptic codes and I'm the code breaker. Searching for signs inside your voice, touch, hand. Haunting echoes of shock. Run for cover. We roam the wide earth like bison. Verging and emerging. Winding around the liquefaction of your smile. It brightens the earth, warms the planet, carries the ocean. It curves to you. The architectural body, nautical legions below, of breathing sheets, of human vulnerability, making interdiscourse. Magnetic nomads nestled and dance. In poetry, facing this dance, crashing like waves into renewal, a mellifluous harmony on violin. Like the Chelsea Hotel.
For more on word performances and all the artists who performed on this evening, please check out the information in the description below this video. Thanks for watching. Check out more at www.catsynth.com and please subscribe to CatSynth TV.